Welcome WBP stars. I'm Chef Nick van der Beken from Aperitif Bali in Ubud. And today we're gonna make a crab dish. It's a Papua crab, very fresh. We're gonna use some parsley root, so also fresh from Bedugul, like you can see. And then we use also kohlrabi. Kohlrabi is also from Bedugul, or from our own garden. The kohlrabi we will pickle. Normal pickle with mustard seed and some cloves. So cloves is from Indonesia. First of all, we're gonna start with boiling the crab. Then from the crab, we take the meat out, and from the shell from the crab, we're gonna make a gulai sauce. So the gulai sauce is a Indonesian kind of fish curry sauce. But let's start with the crab. They are a little bit aggressive. But short pain, boiling water, head first. No suffering. The only one that can suffer is my fingers. There you go. So in the bouillon, we put also spices from Indonesia. So there is a little bit of cloves, there's a little bit of stardanus, there is pepper, there is a little bit of ginger, there is garlic, there is shallot, there is a little bit of chili, there is a little bit of... We also add a little bit of cayenne and a little bit of paprika. So the bouillon is quite spiced. We're gonna go for 5 minutes and then we let it rest. Why we use Papua crab? Papua crab, the meat is more firm and it's a little bit sweeter. So I prefer like this. You can see the meat is nice, white, flaky. But before we make the crab salad, I want to show you how to make the gulai sauce. First of all, we have here all the spices we're gonna use. So we have garlic, we have shallot, lemongrass, chili, lime leaf, galangal, coriander seed. And the main important thing is the turmeric. So for this, coriander seeds are roasted, so you can add everything together. The spices, you can do it with a mortar and pestle, but you can also mix it. You saute all the spices. So always when you make a bumbu, you always have to make sure that the bumbu is saute, right? You get all the flavors, otherwise sometimes it can be a little bit bitter. Of course, we are a little bit fast. We made already crab before. So when I say this dish is zero waste, so we boil the crab, we take the meat out, and then from the meat, when the meat is out, then we use the shells to make the sauce. It's like a bisque, so it's the same base. So many things, going back, all the techniques. inside the box. This I actually get inspired when I went to a room with my wife. We were in the Padang food, so all the food comes in the middle. And there was like a piece of fish with a yellow sauce. I asked what it is. She said, yeah, it's a curry, fish curry. Indonesian fish curry. And I tasted it and it was amazing. So then I started to think what we can do. And I don't want to just get fish curry, but then I was working on a crab dish together with the smoked salmon, and I want to give some sauce. So we made the Indonesian bisque based on the gulai experience in the Padang. Maybe you're wondering why I use smoked salmon and crab, where it comes from. But when I was 18 years old, just turn it off and let it cool down a little bit in the water, and then you're gonna sit down. So all the flavors will be there. So why I do smoked salmon and crab, when I was 18 years old, I had to make, I think, thousands of smoked salmon rolls filled with crab and celeriac and parsley. So this dish started to get me inspired. So we do the crab. Very classic. A little bit of sour cream. In Belgium we use mayonnaise, that's homemade mayonnaise. Pepper. Salt. Just mix it. You can add some horseradish, but we add horseradish to the parsley root. Maybe you will see. After the whole process from reducing and infusing all the flavors, we're gonna strain it, we're gonna reduce it again, and then we add some coconut milk, and then we slowly reduce it again. But for the whole process, it will take too long, so this is the final result. We have the sauce made from the crab shells with all the spices and the coconut milk. We have the crab meat mixed with the sour cream. Sometimes we have tonsil cream, we try it. Then we have the kohlrabi that we slice then we compress with the basic pickle water, with mustard seed, cloves, everything. And then we have the salmon eggs. And instead of smoked salmon, we don't want to overpower the whole dish with the smoked salmon, and we want to be a little bit more innovative. The flavors are still the same. So we use enough. You still want to taste the salmon, so if you put it too long, it's not balanced, you only taste smoke, that's not the point. So for the crab, then we make the citrus gel. It's also with calamansi and with ginger, with the lemon. So to give this fresh touch to the dish. Make sure that every bite you take has the same flavor. We have the pickled kohlrabi. We put on top. You don't want that there is pickle in your crab, so you always put it first on the paper. Make it a little bit drier. You only want the bite in the kohlrabi and the flavor.
this plating to make it more attractive. And also, he's also one of the, or he was one of the biggest chefs who inspired fine dining, quality produce.
That's a Robuchon style, huh? I always think that you have to be proud about some chefs if they do something that you really like. There's no shame to use his ideas. As long as you don't copy exactly what he's doing, and you claim it's yours, it's so cool. Now you see also how many work there is to make one dish. People sometimes forget. They like to criticize very easily, but they don't understand how hard the chefs have to work to create something like this. Inspiration of the smoked salmon with crab from 20 years ago with the bisque, with the Indonesian style curry with the herb, zero waste. I hope you enjoy it.